probing with the inside and outside thigh kicks early. Counter right hand there from Mini T, the Australian in the grey.
I like that Rodtang lead hook that he throws. He throws it almost instead of a jab, he likes to throw that power lead hook. You can see Mini T's trying to paw down the rear hand of Rodtang so he can land that right there. These styles are very similar from these two. But it's that experience advantage that Rodtang has.
Watch a replay of this event in VR in the Venues app on Oculus Quest this Saturday at 8 p.m. Eastern. So I count tattoo on the back there of Mini T, fakes the right hand of the Australian. You see the Prajed armbands around the biceps of Rodtang. Traditionally, they were made by tearing a piece of a mother's sarong and wrapping it around her son's arm for good luck on the battlefield. It's part of a very old Thai tradition that has carried into modern Muay Thai.
Mini T was actually born in Thailand before he transferred over to Australia.
Coming close with that counter right hand is Mini T, Danial Williams. Patient start here from Rodtang.
This is a patient start, but you can tell Rodtang came out immediately and does what Rodtang does. He started taking control of that circle and moving forward.
Showing no signs of being intimidated, Danial Williams. The overwhelming reputation of Rodtang, who is the ONE Super Series world champion. Fake there from Williams. Rodtang wary of that right hand, which Williams pulls off very quickly and with accuracy. Looks for the outside lead thigh. Good cutting half front kick, half side kick there, and a nice one again from Rodtang. Goes downstairs. Corner of Danial Williams are telling him to fight long, and that's what he does. Down the center corridor, long leaping hook there. They want to try and keep Rodtang at the end of Daniel's punches.
Williams is doing a good job of closing that distance, and you can see how Rodtang's utilizing that push kick to try to keep Danial Williams from coming forward.
Yeah, I'll tell you, though, Daniel has found a home for that right hand a couple times now on Rodtang's chin.
It would be a massive upset if Danial Williams can beat Rodtang Jit Muang Non. Rodtang's been on this incredible streak, incredible tear. The biggest winning streak in ONE Super Series. Outside leg kick from the tack. Cross out the jack. Confidence building opening round, I feel, here for the Australian Mini T Danial Williams as we end the opener. Comes out of his corner. Will he up the aggressor meter now? He needs to. It was an unfamiliar slow start from Rodtang in the opening round.
This is typically where we see Rodtang level up and shift gears. And he starts to put a little bit more fire behind his shots.
Inside leg to that. Femoral profunda there. And another one from Rodtang. Goes to the inside leg a third time.
You can hear those leg kicks landing from the booth here.
One way to slow down the boxing of your opponent is to kick the legs, because every good punch begins from the bottom of the feet and works its way up the body until it exits out of the fists. So if you can kick the legs, you can effectively slow down the boxing. And we know the boxing was effective of Danial Williams in the first round. As Rich noted, he did almost find the target with the right hand. And there's a nice little turning left hook, almost a gazelle punch there from Mini T.
I think that left hook from Rodtang just hurt Danial Williams there.
Another one from Rodtang. A mandible rally. Oh, the big kibosh! Mini T went down. The left hook from Rodtang.
Mitch called it. This is when Rodtang always switches to another gear in the second round.
Daniel Williams says he's okay to go on, but the cobwebs are still there. And here comes Rodtang. This is danger now for Williams. Spinning back elbow from Mini T. The Australian's got a long time to survive this round with Rodtang on the front foot. Another left hook. Overhand elbow, crossing elbow, uppercut elbow. The full Muay Thai repertoire here from Rodtang.
A lot of people try to run from Rodtang, but Mini T is not backing down, but he's got to move.
Mini T staying inside the phone booth, but he's got to get out of danger. Beautiful tape kick to the midsection of the Australian.
Yeah, out comes the Iron Man now. Danial T has got to start moving, because that range is lighting him up.
These elbows, the most dangerous weapon in Muay Thai. Rodtang consistently on the front foot, uppercut elbow. Mini T's cut over the left eye. Rodtang has lit him up here in the second round.
Yeah, you can tell Rodtang there got a little emotional after he caught that knockdown and was getting a little overzealous for the knockout, but now he's kind of composed himself and he's really starting to pick his shots intelligently with those elbows.
We usually see Rodtang take opponents apart with his hands. Tonight, though, he's looking for the elbow knockout. Look at the slice and dice and fillet Williams. But Williams is not prepared to wave the white flag here, Dragon.
Yeah, he is standing in the pocket, not changing his game, not running. Still willing to go toe-to-toe.
Stiff right hand on the inside there from Mini T. Rodtang sticks a foot in his face. What a tremendous round for Rodtang. He'll take it 10-8 on the judges' scorecard following that knockdown. Round to cover now for Mini T. He needs a knockdown on Rodtang to have any hopes here. And you know what, Rich, as you said, he's got heat in the hands, has the Australian. If Rodtang makes a mistake, if Rodtang gets lazy, Williams can expose him.
Especially with these 4-ounce gloves. That's one thing that the fans got to keep in mind here is they're not using the big gloves. This is Muay Thai with 4-ounce gloves. And I love the way Mini T just started out this round aggressively.
How's this from Mini T now with the elbows? We saw a jumping downward elbow, a cranium cracker earlier on. There's a two-punch combination from the Aussie. Rodtang does a quick count of his teeth. Mini T's not going to go anywhere quietly. A crossing elbow from Mini T.
Hats off to the competition team for making this matchup because they picked a perfect opponent for Rodtang. Mini T is in this, ladies and gentlemen.
Danial Williams goes to the outside back thigh of Rodtang. Rodtang in southpaw start. Overhand right there from Williams. Guts and intestinal fortitude on the Aussie. Body shot, belly button through the back. Misses with the left. You can hear the heavy breathing of Williams, and he's still inside that phone booth, still training with Rodtang. Doesn't want to take a backward step. My word, this is a game plan we never see anyone employ against Rodtang. Careful. Overhand right from Rodtang. Williams goes to the leg. Looks for a downward elbow. The collarbone is the target. Overhand elbows from both.
Nice little fake, the push kick, and the late into jab from Rodtang as he switched stances to come forward. I like the diversity of elbows coming from Mini T, though.
Beautiful uppercut elbow off the right arm from Rodtang, and a crossing elbow, sock to it, it's known as in Muay Thai. Another crossing elbow, trying to take his ear off, the old Van Gogh technique. Body shot. You hear the connection on some of these blows with the 4-ounce gloves. It is frightening, Rich.
Yeah, and you can see that when Mini T landed that shot on Rodtang, he did what Rodtang does. He said, no, I don't like that. And he goes ahead and put his hands down and waiting for another one.
Rodtang's cut. It looks like a cut on the hairline of Rodtang.
Who would have thought Mini T would be in this match 30 seconds to go playing this game with Rodtang? Standing there toe-to-toe.
At yesterday's press conference, Danial Williams said, I want to make my name worldwide against Rodtang. He is certainly doing that. What a performance from the Australian. He's got to think, though, what would have happened if he hadn't have got dropped in the second round. It's been a great third round for Mini T. And look at the respect, the integrity, the honor of these two martial arts warriors.
Red corner, Rodtang Jinwanda!
A winning streak continues.